Hey everyone, it's Sam here, and I've got a video to show you about my project, SEADOVE, a novel emergency locator system, which I started because of flight QZ8501 that crashes into the ocean back in 2014, resulting in many lost lives, including some of the people that I know. Following that incident, I did more research and found out that there are a couple of similar airplane accidents, and I'll list them here on the screen. And it includes a very recent airplane accident in Indonesia that happened less than a month ago by the time of this video upload. From all the airplane crashes I listed, nobody survived because it took too long to locate the airplane crash and the current emergency system still works insufficiently. Let me explain why. So there are three main devices used for helping to locate the crash coordinates. The first one is the emergency locator transmitter. ELT does not work underwater, which makes it unreliable for this kind of crash scenarios. The second one is underwater locator beacon, which only transmits ping signals, so it does not send location data, and it only has very limited reach. The third one is the ADS-B tracking system, which works fine when the airplane is above the land, but when the airplane is above the ocean, there are many blank spots, which makes it hard to track the airplane accurately at all times. Due to these limitations, I developed SEADOVE. Now I'm going to explain how SEADOVE works. Let's say we're going from location A to B, and in the middle of the trip, an accident happened, causing the airplane to crash into the ocean. When an impact is detected, SEADOVE will be ejected from the tail of the airplane. At the same time, SEADOVE will get GPS coordinates of the crash location. There's also another device that I call FTS, which will be located in strategic spots in the ocean. All the FTS's location is already stored in SEADOVE's memory, so it knows where all the FTS's are. Directly after the impact, SEADOVE will send crash location and SOS distress signal, which can be received by passersby. But it is mainly to be transmitted to the FTS, so it can be relayed and received by the rescue coordination center. And if the nearest FTS is still too far from the initial SEADOVE location, aka the crash coordinates, SEADOVE will head towards the nearest FTS, which is this one. Once the safe and rescue coordination center got the exact crash coordinates, they can send help immediately.